After visiting his lawyers' offices, Amama Mbabazi convened a press conference at the Go Forward offices in Nakasero today. The former independent presidential candidate, who is challenging the victory of President Museveni, told reporters that the break-in at lawyers Mohammad Mbabazi's offices was carried out by police and somewhere from Wandegea police station.
We are definitely sure, I am informed, that because there were eyewitnesses, those who raided Mr. Muhammad's chambers, the legal firm of Muhammad and Company Limited, were about 30 in number, and the majority of them were in police uniform. Therefore, and it was just behind the police station in Wandegea, as you know.
Mbabazi says he has never seen anything of such nature, even during Idi Amin's regime.
I can only say that I really don't know what to say. I don't know what words to use to describe this state of affairs. It's unheard of. I've not heard of lawyers' chambers being raided by state machinery.
The former independent presidential candidate also said documents, computers, hard disks and affidavits related to the amended petition in the Supreme Court were taken by their silence. He also added that the state is hunting people who could bolster his election petition at the Supreme Court, including key witnesses to the election fraud committed by the candidate Yoweri Museveni.
Incredible coincidence, if at all, that these raids were done a few hours before filing was to begin at 9 o'clock this morning. In both chambers, files were carried away, computers, laptops, and so on were carried away, and we have no idea where they are. Did raise the matter with the Supreme Court about 14 of our witnesses that had come to give evidence, they had come to swear affidavits, and they were arrested by police just outside my residence as they were turning in. And up to now, we don't know exactly where they are. We've been trying to trace them. That day, they were taken to Kireka. I don't know whether.
And one of his lawyers, Medad Wega Segona, said a meeting of the entire legal team was due to assess the situation. Mbabazi also warned that the police has taken its mandate to an accepted level and that this action needs to be checked out if Uganda is to avoid from sliding into a police state.
If the actions of the police are not contained by the state, by government, Uganda is surely and very quickly sliding into a police state. In other words, where political issues are decided by using the police instead of obviously applying democratic methods. And this is a travesty.